Hi everyone, welcome to the channel. Today we have this sum of fractions 1 over 2 plus 1 over 6 plus 1 over 12 plus 1 over 20 plus blah 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 plus 1 over 9900. This sum of fractions actually cannot be dealt with by making the denominators the same. So many denominators, we will see some property of these fractions that this 2 is just 1 times 2, this 6 is 2 times 3, this 12 is 3 times 4, and this is 4 times 5, blah blah blah, this is 99 times 100. So we have two consecutive numbers, integers, the product of two consecutive integers in the denominator. Now let's say this is 1 over x times x plus 1, and we wanna write this as some a plus x plus a divided by x, sorry, plus b divided by x plus 1. So from this, we will find this A and B by writing this, actually multiplying this by x plus 1 and the second one by x. And we will write 1 is equal to A times x plus 1 plus B times x. This is a polynomial equation. The left and right-hand sides will be equal, the x terms left-hand side is 0x, and right-hand side that is ax plus bx, which is a plus b is the coefficient, and the constant term here is 1, the constant term right-hand side is just a. So this gives a is already equal to 1 and b should be equal to negative 1, 2. A plus B is equal to 0. So 1 over x times x plus 1 is equal to A over x plus 1. A over x, actually, let's see. A over x plus B over x plus 1. A is 1, 1 over x plus negative 1 or minus 1 divided by x plus 1. This is the identity we derived from these operations. Now, my friends, we will use these like that. Now, our first fraction is 1 over 2, which is 1 over 1 times 2. This is equal to, from this rule, 1 over 1 minus 1 over 2. And the second one, 1 over 6, is equal to 1 over 2 times 3. This is equal to 1 over 2 minus 1 over 3, you can check, and so on and so forth. 1 over 12 is 1 over 3 times 4, and this is 1 over 3 minus 1 over 4. Let's just put these numbers into our sum. We have 1 half plus 1 over 6 plus 1 over 12 plus so on and so forth to 1 over 9900. The first one is 1 minus 1 half. Second one was 1 half minus 1 third. The third one was 1 third minus 1 fourth, and so on and so forth. The last one will become 1 over 99 minus 1 over 100. And I think you get the idea here. This minus and plus negative 1 half, actually 1 half, will cancel. Negative and positive 1 third will cancel. 1 fourth will cancel. And from last two, 1 over 99s will cancel. So we are left with 1 and negative 1 over 100. This is 1 minus 1 over 100, and that's 99 divided by this 100. That's our final result. Thank you for watching and see you in the next videos.